My favorite corner in the world is right there on Barton Springs Road. It's the home of Chuy's Tex-Mex. That's the finest Tex-Mex food you'll find in all of Texas and the best Mexican food you'll find in the whole world. It's right there on Barton Springs Road in Austin. A lot of interesting things go on there. You'll see some great sights, including this is it's Barton Creek, and it's running into Lady Bird Lake, which is right across from downtown Austin. This town is just full of all kinds of running trails and exercise areas, places to take your dog, places to walk your children. It's a real outdoor city. There's also, that's a municipal auditorium that you saw where some of the great concerts have been held through the years. But any given Saturday morning or Sunday morning when school's out or just not working, this is where you'll find folks outside playing with their dogs and congregating together, and sometimes around the Stevie Ray Vaughan statue. That's the old guy who was the great blues player from the 70s and 80s, and particularly the 80s. He died in a plane crash and is kind of a native son of Austin. People still remember Stevie Ray. No, that's not Southern California you're looking at. That's actually Lake Travis, which is about 30 miles out of town, and this is not an old dilapidated building. That's Willie Nelson's Country Club, Briarcliff. It's called Perdinales Country Club. This is inside the country club at Willie's. You'll see some of his memorabilia there, and you can pick up a cap or T-shirt. Just let them know you're there, and you'll never forget where you were when you go out on the golf course, because there you'll see that Texas flag flying over those beautiful, beautiful scrub oaks and mesquite trees. Beautiful place. This is Willie's neighborhood. Anytime, and it's open to the public. You're allowed to go there and play if you'd like. This is Luck, Texas. This is actually a western town that Willie Nelson had built back in the 80s to do the movie called Redheaded Stranger, and you can see to check that movie out. This is inside the studio where Willie recorded off some of his greatest hits.
It's essentially our main cutting room. We have a control room. The control room's over here. There's a vocal booth here, and there's a piano room around the way. But I have played a little main, rock and roll. Where, you know, drums or any really any part of the late 80s were kind of the heyday out here, I would say. But
but the Pancho and Lefty album was done here.
A lot of those records, yeah, a lot of pieces of those records were done here, whether they were mixed here or whether they were
But you also lease the studio out for anybody that's doing projects.
It is too. It is a public studio. Whoever
calls. All right.
For the most part.
Of course,
They both played great music. They just called it different names. But if you put it all together, it will still come out the same. Give me a steel guitar. She said the other perks in the studio would be that we are full digital and still full analog.
There's some people that still want to stay with analog too.
A lot of people are still wanting to stay with analog. It's definitely had a resurgence. But this studio is full 48 track digital and 24 track digital or tape. And then also full capability to mix down the tape as well. So you can multi-track to tape, multi-track to dig, or mix to dig, mix to tape. A lot of old analog gear. A lot of
it sounds good, keep it.
Yeah, exactly. A lot of old vintage mics and vintage amps.
It's recorded.
Yeah, that's fine. All I need.